Let's finish up our discussion of bonding by talking about metallic compounds. The metallic bond is very different from the ionic and the covalent bond in that the electrons are delocalized. Specifically, the valence electrons have the ability to move freely between all of the atoms present. In this illustration, the positive signs are representing atoms that are tightly packed together. So you can see the positive nuclei are tightly packed together, and then the electrons are moving freely throughout the structure. This is often called a sea of electrons, and it explains many of the properties that we see with a metal. Metals are malleable, which means that you can bend them. They are ductile, which means that you can draw them into wires. If there were strong covalent or ionic bonds between these atoms, you would not be able to bend them or draw them into wires. So this sea of electrons allows motion between the atoms. Metals are also great conductors of electricity because electricity results from moving electrons. So the movement of these electrons allows for electricity to transfer. Metals also have luster, which means that they are shiny. The electrons on the outer surface of the metal serve as a barrier that prevents light from entering in as well as it normally would. That causes the light to bounce off and gives the metal the shiny appearance that we are used to. So many of the properties that we are familiar with metals, are explained by this sea of electrons, the idea that the valence electrons for metallic atoms are delocalized. Whenever other substances are added to a pure metal, an alloy is formed. Here you have a pure metal where nothing has been added. You should notice that there is an arrangement to the atoms. There's a pattern to the way that they are arranged in the structure. The first type of alloy that I would like to show you is a substitutional alloy. In a substitutional alloy, atoms from the pattern have been removed and a new atom has been put into their place. So in a substitutional alloy, atoms have been substituted into the original pattern of the pure metal. Bronze is an example of a substitutional alloy. Bronze is made up of mostly copper atoms, with 10 atoms substituting some of those coppers. This will change many of the physical properties of the substance. Copper and bronze will have different colors, different hardnesses. They'll be different in the way that they bend. They just function differently. So an alloy has different properties than the pure metal that it originated from. The other type of alloy is an interstitial alloy. In an interstitial alloy, the original pattern has not been disrupted. However, other atoms have been inserted into the gaps for the pattern. Steel is an example of an interstitial alloy, where the majority of the atoms are made up of iron, and there are carbon atoms inserted into the gaps between the pattern. The properties of steel are very different than the properties for iron. And there are many different types of steel out there that depend on the amount of carbon that has been added or if any other atoms have been added. You can also have alloys that are a combination of substitutional and interstitial alloys. In this example, the blue atoms are substitutional. They have replaced one of the original atoms. And the green atoms are interstitial. They have been inserted into the gaps. One thing that I'd like to point out is that the size of the atom helps determine what type of alloy will form. In the case of a substitutional alloy, the original atom and the substituted atom tend to be fairly close in size. However, in the case of an interstitial alloy, the original atom tends to be much larger than the atom that has been inserted into the gaps. This has been a very brief introduction to alloys, but I do want to point out that there are entire courses and curriculums available for understanding metals and understanding alloys. It's crucial that an engineer who's designing a high-rise choose the appropriate type of steel to make sure that the building can sway but not collapse. Or someone designing a bridge has to choose the right metals to make sure that it can carry a certain amount of weight. So depending on what you want to major in, an in-depth understanding of alloys may be in your future. That concludes our unit on bonding. Stick around as we start to learn about stoichiometry.